What's going on, you guys? It's your boy Caesar, and I have a minoxidil beard update for you guys. So as you guys know, if you watched my last video, I winged off minoxidil at the year and a half mark, okay? It took me, 6 weeks to wing off of it, if I remember correctly. So I am having issues, you guys. Let me show you what I'm talking about. If you guys could like see right here, it's that hole, it's that patch that I've had. I hate it. I just can't stress you guys how much I hate this little patch right here. Okay, so this side is actually okay. I could notice that it kind of thinned out, like especially like where that patch is, right? It kind of thinned out in that area and then kind of like on top right here. This is where I mainly notice like the thinning right here. But this side looks okay, right? If it looked like this side, I'd say on this side, like both sides, I would probably stop minoxidil. I mean, pretty much call it quits from there, but I just can't, I can't stop. Like, I want a full beard. That's the reason I started my journey. I have a lot of you guys, you know, following me, commenting, showing love. I appreciate everybody in the comments, and I, you know, you guys are the greatest. I do have a couple haters out there, but for the most part, you know, you guys are showing me love, and I really appreciate that. That's why I love doing these videos for you guys. But back on topic. So that spot right there, like it just got to me. So let's rewind back a little bit. So at the, I stopped using minoxidil, and I'd say about 2 months after, right? I started looking in the mirror and I was kind of like, it kind of looks a little light right there, you know? And I would ask my wife, like, baby, do you see anything like going on? She's like, no, it looks good, looks good. And then like, I just kept looking at it. And I was like, I didn't want to go back to my videos and look at like how it looked when I stopped at the 1.5 year mark. So I was like, come on, please tell me it's not shedding. So anyways, the last straw was I was eating, I believe, scrambled eggs, if I remember correctly. And it was on a white plate. It was in the morning, it was on a white plate. And I noticed like a little hair right there. And I was like, man, it was my beard hair. It's a little nasty. I know it was kind of like by the scrambled eggs, but the point of it is, I was like, you know what? That is my beard hair and it is shedding and I need to address this. And I was like, I went back, saw my videos, and I was like, you know what? It's definitely shedding. I'm gonna show you guys a clip of what it looked like when I stopped at the 1.5 year mark. So this is what it looks like right now. You can see that patch, right? So boom. This is what it looked like at the 1.5 year mark when I was still using and I was right about to stop using. So that's like the fullest it's ever been, okay? This side, if you guys wanna check out the left side, this is what it looks like right now. And then this is what it looks like at the 1.5 year mark. You guys could see that it looked a lot better at the 1.5 year mark, okay? So that's why I am gonna restart using minoxidil. Lucky for you guys, I'm gonna continue, you know, documenting my journey in videos. And I wanted to talk about some stuff in this video. So one of the things that I said was I use Rogaine, right? I use Rogaine and it's a name brand and this is it, this is legit, right? So one thing you gotta factor is how long you're gonna be using, right? So I'm not sure when I'm gonna stop, but definitely over the 2 year mark, like 2.5 year mark maybe. Like we could talk about that when I get to that point. But the thing is like the Rogaine is it's more on the expensive side for that minoxidil, right? So what I did is I got this from Costco. It's the Kirkland minoxidil and this is the 6 bottles, okay? It's the same size as this, right? 6 bottles, it's still the 5%. Let me find it for you guys right there. Still 5% minoxidil. So I'm gonna be using that instead of the Rogaine. You know, it's all the same stuff. All the ingredients are there. I know in one of my first videos, I was like, name brand, but it's really not about the name brand. It's about the long game. So it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. And if you're gonna, you know, keep it up, keep putting it on your beard, you want to have the lowest out-of-pocket cost. So that's why I went with Kirkland instead of going for Rogaine. I have a little bit in this bottle left. I'm gonna finish this off. And then when I do, I'm gonna open up the minoxidil Kirkland style. So I have been using the minoxidil for 1 week now. I haven't noticed anything, any of the side effects that's on the back of it, like, you know, racing heart, any of that stuff. I haven't noticed any of that stuff. It's like I didn't skip a beat. I just kept it rolling. I have not noticed any hair loss on the top of my head yet. I still use the hair fibers, you know, to cover up my thinning. I was already thinning before I did minoxidil, so of course I'm gonna thin on minoxidil. And I still get a lot of questions of that, like when did I, you know, see that I stopped thinning and when did I start growing my hair again? So it was about the 2.5 month mark when I started noticing my hair was thinning even more than it already was, right? I was, you know, losing hair. I was, you know, shampooing it up and I would look at my hands and I would see hair everywhere. And I was like, what is going on? You know, and that's when I had to, you know, do more research, find out that it's normal to shed. I have people in the comments saying, you know, no, it's not normal to shed. For me, it's normal. I did my research. It is 100% normal. Like, I don't know what else to tell you guys. Like, there's people in the comment box that think otherwise. But anyways, it's normal to thin out on top, okay? I have a lot of people asking me, you know, should I do it? Should I not do it? The choice is yours if you want to do it. But you got to know that that is a possible side effect that you're going to be losing some hair on top, right? So that's your choice to make, not my choice. I can't make it for you guys. And, you know, I think it's cool that you guys trust me with that and are asking me. But, like, you know, the choice is ultimately yours, okay? So I'm gonna let you guys know if I'm gonna be thinning out this time around. I hope I'm not, since I was already using minoxidil and I stopped for a little while, 4 months to be exact. So I hope that my body is still used to the minoxidil, having it, you know, in my body, and, you know, hopefully I get to keep my hair, because I'm telling you guys, I am thinning on top. Like, I have the Hair Topic fibers in right now. You know, sprinkle it on top, make it look nice. But yeah, I'm gonna keep you guys updated if I do start shedding hair on the top of my head. And also, I keep talking about the people in the comment box, but they're like, what does your, you know, applying minoxidil to your beard have to do with your head? And you guys, the minoxidil, it goes all the way through your skin. It doesn't just go in your hair, it goes all the way through your skin. It goes to the blood vessels, it goes in your bloodstream. And then, so it could affect your whole body. So your whole body could shed. You could start growing back hair. You know, you could have no back hair, you're using minoxidil, it could affect your back hair. Some people have, you know, start getting hairier legs with it. Some people shed. You know, it just, some people actually that use it on top of their head start noticing that they're growing out a beard. So, you know, that's just one thing to be cautioned about, to have caution with when you're, you know, deciding if you're gonna use it or not. Brings me to my next point. Okay, so I do have a lot of young viewers that are like 16, they're 17, some of them are 15, and they wanna have a beard. And I know you guys, like, I know, I was there too. You wanna be manly, you wanna look all that, but, like, you guys have to wait. Like, let nature do its part. You guys could actually still grow out a beard. Like, there's no magical number, but, I mean, I wanna put, like, 21 on it. Like, if you guys are younger than 21, you probably shouldn't be using minoxidil. Like, you guys, you don't wanna mess with your body. Your body is still growing. You could still have hair coming out, and it'd be better to have it come out naturally than, you know, using a product like minoxidil. So, you know, you guys also hit me up, and I just wanna be real with you guys and let you guys know that it's probably better that you don't use it at a young age. You know, the choices, again, like I said, up to you. But I would prefer, if you guys were my son and I had to tell you guys, like, you know, if you guys asked me, I would tell you straight up, no, do not use it until you're at least 21. Okay, so let's bring it back for a second. We're gonna talk about the vellus hairs and the terminal hairs. So vellus hairs are the baby hairs that grow out, and you can start seeing them growing out. I'd say some people, like, comment, like, a week of using minoxidil, they start seeing all the hair coming out. Mine took a little bit longer than that, but you're gonna see, like, little bit of baby hair, okay? Those are called the vellus hairs. Those will eventually turn into the big hairs or the terminal hairs. And the terminal hairs are the ones that are supposed to stay once they grow out, but in my case, and in anybody else's case that stopped a little bit too early, you guys are gonna notice that you thought that they were terminal hairs, you thought that they were real grown hairs because they're nice and thick, right? But for some weird reason, once you stop using minoxidil, they start falling off. And I don't plan on using minoxidil my whole life. I do want to use it for a little bit longer. And I mean, that's kind of like my next question, like how long do I plan on using minoxidil? And like I said a little bit earlier on, I want to kind of like use it for 2.5 years and kind of like reevaluate the situation there. But I mean, if I have to use it for 3 years, I'll use it for 3 years. Like, I want a beard, and that's why I'm doing this. Like, I know I'm gonna be thinning on top more and more and more as, you know, time goes by. For those that are wondering, I am 36 years old. So I, you know, I haven't had a full beard my whole life. So I waited until I was, 35 to start using and to start, you know, having a beard. So especially for the, you know, the younger viewers that are watching, like, guys, wait until I was 35. It's cool. Just wait, you know, let nature do its thing. So back to how long I'm planning on using. So yeah, 2.5 years, maybe 3 years, do a reevaluation. You know, you guys let me know what you think about that, you know, in the comment box below. But I would like to use it definitely more than 2.5 years. Another question I get a lot is, can you shave while you're on minoxidil? And my answer is yes, okay? I have shaved when I was on minoxidil. I don't like shaving. I like to have it like nice and trimmed. If you guys are wondering, this is a number 5 on the side and number 6 down here at the bottom with the clippers. So you can shave. Yes, you can shave. I have a lot of people in the comment box, like again, like, they're trying to take over my video. Like, so I say you can shave because the thing is, you're shaving your hairs, right? It's not, you still have like a little bit of hair coming out your skin. It's not like you're drilling into your skin and carving your root out, okay? You're just shaving the top layers of your skin. The minoxidil could, it's even better if you shave, in my opinion, because it gives the minoxidil like a straight shot to your roots to actually go in your bloodstream and start working. So if anything, if you want it to work and not use a lot, because think about it, when you have a lot more hair, you're gonna have to spray more of the foam and start using the foam more, you know, because it's gonna soak into the hair, and then the point of it is getting into your skin. So yes, you can shave. Definitely you can shave. So, you know, people in the comment box, say what you want, but in my opinion, this is my video, I can say my opinion. I say if you shave, it does not affect your hair growing out whatsoever when you're on minoxidil. Okay, so now my next point is Dermarol. So I said that I was gonna use Dermarol, right? And I still haven't used it because I wanted to see if, you know, the hair that I had was due to either minoxidil or the Dermarol. So if I was using both at the same time, I couldn't really document and I couldn't really know which one was taking over and which one was actually working. That's why I did my video this way, and that's why I did it like that, so I could, you know, find out. Cause like, think about it. Like, if I was using Dermarol right now, maybe that patch would have been filled in, right? So I wouldn't know that the minoxidil didn't do its thing, right? So I would still be thinking like, oh yeah, minoxidil, you know, still did its thing. I'm using Dermarol now. So my thing is like, I know that the minoxidil is, it's still too early to get off of it. So I'm gonna start, I already started using minoxidil, but I'm gonna start Dermarolling now. And then it's kind of gonna be using it, you know, in conjunction with the minoxidil. So now it's gonna be, hey, I don't know if it's gonna be the Dermarol, you know, actually working because I'm back on minoxidil, but there's no other way that I could do it. And I, you know, wanna have a full beard. So either way, if it's the minoxidil, if it's the Dermarol, giving me a full beard, filling in that nasty patch that I have right here, just, I, guys, I hate it. And I know there's people watching that are like, man, I wish I had your beard. Like, I wish I was that full, but I want to have a full beard. And that's like, that's my number one thing. Like, I don't want to have this patch right here. I started this journey And I'm definitely way better than day one. Don't get me wrong, you guys. If you guys want to see day one, this is what day one looks like for those new viewers, or if you haven't seen any of my other videos, but this is day one, and man, patches everywhere. Patch City. Like, right now, it does look great, but like, guys, I just look in the mirror and I do other videos and I'm like, man, I see myself and I'm editing and I'm like, man, what's up with that patch right there? Like, why can't I grow it in? Anyways, if you guys got some information, please like this video. Comment down below. If you're gonna hate on me, go ahead, hate on me. I'll answer you guys. You know, hopefully my supporters, you know, hit that thumbs up so it'll outweigh the thumbs down and outweigh the haters and all that good stuff. You guys already know what to do. Subscribe if you want to keep following my journey. And please, you guys, any questions, of course, comment box below.